Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's my privilege and honor to have Minako to join our show. Minako, all the way from New York City, and welcome to The Missing Piece.
Hi, Will. It's my pleasure to join your show. Thank you for having me.
Well, again, Minako, these days, it's so fascinating. It's so interesting to talk about art. Now, let's get to the question right away. So the first question, Minako, I wanted to ask you is, why did you decide to create the piece of art in the midst of the whole political division? And what message are you trying to convey, not only to the people in America, but also to the audience and to the visitors across the world?
Well, the piece of art. I created Lovers statue. It's a marble monument of two people hugging each other. And it's a symbol of connection. And one is in New York and the other one is Japan. The original inspiration for this statue came from September 11 attack in New York 20 years ago. And somehow the message is still fresh today because of all the different kind of division, including political division, which is kind of sad. And I just moved to the United States from Japan in 3 days before September 11 attack happened. I was so close to World Trade Center on that day. And I still remember it was such a beautiful day with clear blue sky. I just couldn't believe what was happening in front of my eyes. Then something I realized was, oh, I didn't know the reality of the world. Just like any ordinary other Japanese people who were born after World War II in my country, I somehow believed this world is okay. We're not going to make any more terrible war, and no one going to use nuclear weapon anymore. But that was just an illusion. And since then, I have been always thinking about what divided the people. Is it religions or races or politics or nations? Whatever. I thought if there are people who destroy and divide the world, and I wanted to become a person to create and connect the world. So I decided to carve the 12-foot marble statue called Lovers to deliver the message. Everyone, let's just connect each other and let's connect the world. So that was my message.
Well, Minako, it's so inspiring to hear that you actually create this piece of artwork called Lovers. And again, the word that you use, it said you're trying to use this piece of work to connect the people together. I mean, again, I can't remember. I mean, today, even though when I thought about September 11th, it's one of the days that, you know, I hate to use the word unforgettable, because it's not something that rather positive for us to remember, but it's actually shook the entire world. And of course, that today, when we living in this country, and again, not just in America, but across the continent, people always say separation is better than unification, mainly because we have different interests and we have different political preference. And most importantly, that we no longer see each other as us. You know, it's instead we rather divide the entire universe into us versus them. So it's rather tragic. But looking at your story and looking at you as an artist to create this masterpiece to bring the people together, especially as an immigrant, that is so unique. And again, it's so motivational. Now, let's talk about your journey of being an artist. I mean, you as an immigrant and you moved to this country and then you witness all these years, the transition, the ups and downs. Can you share with us what inspired you to be an artist at the beginning? And how does that How does the political change or social change strengthen your decision continue to be an artist?
So maybe I need to share my life story a little bit with your audience.
Please.
Enjoy. Yeah. You know, I always loved to create artwork since I was 2 years old. But my father was a serious banker. You can imagine, right? And
right.
He didn't believe that people could make a living by art.
Mm.
And which is kind of true. I have no complaint to my father. But I just wanted to try. And I seriously started to go to Musashino Art University while I was still working at a travel agency in Tokyo. And as soon as I graduated, I came to the United States. I didn't know anyone in New York, and I have very little savings, but I was very happy to follow my dream because this is the place you can do that. And then back then I was a painter, and I didn't plan to become a sculptor at all. But one day I found many beautiful marble blocks in a trash container at the construction site near Ground Zero, but that was after the September 11 attack. So when I saw them, I felt so sad, and I thought the marble was screaming to me, Minako, please help, something like that. And I couldn't just ignore this voice, and I decided to make something beautiful from this abandoned marble. But you know, of course, I was a painter. I didn't know anything about carving stone, marble sculpture. So I went to the Art Student League on 57th Street to learn how to carve stone. This changed my entire life. And my first piece was very small, around maybe 14 inches high, and it was already too heavy and too difficult for me. As you can imagine, carving stone is only one way, and once you break it, you can make a mistake and you cannot go back. And it is not only front and back, but it has to be correct at all different kind of angles.
That's right.
So I thought this would be my first and the last piece, and I would never ever carve marble sculpture anymore. This is just too difficult. I'm not smart enough to continue this. So that was my first impression. But this first piece won a scholarship from the league, and since then I have been carving stone. I personally hope that my artwork, like any artwork in the world, can be something like a good friend. Like right after September 11 attack, I was by myself. I didn't have any friend because I just arrived from Japan. And I wanted to see something beautiful. And I don't want you to have this kind of experience, but when something like huge rocks, huge destroy in front of us, like human naturally, we wanted to see something beautiful. That's something I felt. And I walk around in the city and all the museum closed, but I found the angel statues in the Columbus Circle. And this angel statues become my first and oldest friend in New York. So a public art, such as a monument and memorial, are always welcoming you. Even museum closed there outside, and they welcome you 24 hours, 7 days, anytime you need, anytime you want to cry, they're
That's
there.
Right.
They're there for you.
That's right.
So, and they have no discrimination if you're poor, if you're rich, if you're Japanese or American or Muslim, and they just welcome anyone. And I just like this concept so much. And I hope my lovers that can be like a connection point that people can meet, even this world is dividing. Mm. But you can't, we cannot live by ourselves.
That's right.
And then, so that's my perspective as an artist.
Well, Minako, you said it very well, but I want to have and following up question is, since you created this piece, The Lovers, have you heard any visitors or have you heard from anyone that who actually, just as what you said, because it's a public sculpture, it's a public a piece of art, and anyone is welcome to visit, anyone is welcome to appreciate what you created. But have you heard from any visitors or anyone to say, you know, this piece of art actually, how can I say, brings a comfort or brings healings to me, or I was deeply touched by your work. Can you share with us a little bit about some of the feedbacks that you got after creating this piece of art?
Yes. You know, the 12 pieces of statue, creating 12 pieces of statue, it's not easy. I thought I was going to die because I was working on it 18 hours every day.
Wow.
And yes, I didn't want to do that again, but just because I studied, I wanted to complete this. Okay. Mm. So whatever, I couldn't sleep maybe I sleep only 2 hours every day.
Mm.
And it's just like working. But the day we installed Lovers in the Riverside Park in New York, it was a beautiful day. It had blue sky with a cloud, like a wave.
Mm.
And the Lovers is so white, Lovers, right? Lovers statue is white, and it came from, it's almost like from the universe or the sky, and they arrived in New York. And that moment, I was almost lose myself because it was just so beautiful.
Mm.
And that piece made me happy. But then next is the people surround the statue. And I don't know anyone, but they were just congratulate me. And they came to me and they said, they gave me heart like Lovers, and they said, oh, Minako, thank you very much for creating this piece.
Mm.
And some people started to cry in front of me, and they said, I don't know what kind of religious they believe or where they're from, what nationality, but most of the people in front of me, they said, oh, Minako, I feel something more beyond bigger than just like a man and a woman, and it's more like universal love. So when they said that, I was deeply touched because that's something I wanted to try to make it happen. And even and that it's actually I did the same kind of presentation for the New York City. But they didn't listen to my presentation, but they just felt what I tried to tell through my art. That was just something magical moment. And it's not only once, and every time I met someone in front of Lovers, they kept saying that, and they're from all over the world.
Mm.
It was just wonderful.
Of course, Minako. I mean, again, just as you are retelling the moments that during the dedication ceremony that people came to you, and again, because I always say this way, Minako, to be honest, I am not an artist, but every time I walk into an art museum, just by looking around or by touring around the entire place, every single picture or every single sculpture, whatever the message was originally intended, I, as a visitor, as an outsider, I always tend to find the connection with the creator at the first place. And the second thing I believe, as what you were saying, there's a story, or there should be a story, that for the audience to appreciate the hard work behind each masterpiece. So that's why it's amazing that how people came to you. Again, the name is called Lovers, but also at the beginning you use the word to connect. So in other words, the piece of art, it's not just a platform, it's not just an art that beautify the riverside, but it's a mechanism that wake up the people in New York and wake up the people in America to understand how an immigrant today sees the country, or maybe perhaps propose the way that the country should move forward. But with that said, now let's go back to the issue with immigrant. You know, today, I don't want to sound too political, is the issue of immigration, it's actually standing at the crossroads. And I'm sure that you, as getting a lot more attention through your artwork and also your creations and your art, you pay attention to those matters as well. Maybe you have the conversation with the people around you. But the next question is, why do you think today the immigrants as us should pay attention, or should understand what's going on in American society today, and what role do we play in this modern American world?
After I installed the second Lovers in Japan last year, I couldn't come back to New York because of the world pandemic of COVID-19. And I saw lots of news that Asian women were attacked in the city, somewhere on the street, somewhere. And everyone in Japan was so worried, and they said, oh, Minako, you did enough in the United States. You don't need to go back to the United States. Right? Especially my mom. She was just crying, oh, Minako, you're going to die over it, something like that. But you know, I just need to ignore everyone. I wouldn't say ignore. I listen to them, but I have to think by myself again and again. And should I stay in Japan or go back to the United States? Then, I mean, after really many days, I came up with the answer. The United States and people in New York gave me the opportunity, the chance to become an artist. And now as an artist, I wanted to help recreate the city or recreate the country. And then it might be something very small, like making a peace monument might not change this country situation dynamically, but I thought it's okay, because we as an immigrant, or we as a human, we must continue whatever we can do.
That's right.
For our society with your best. And this country was built by immigrants. And the power of each of us might be very small, but I believe we are like glued to connect someone different in this country. And then I believe, and I knew, we are the proof or the evidence that all different kind of people can live together in this world. And this is how I think our role as an immigrant in the United States.
This is a very humble, but it's a very, again, I guess the word humble is not even good enough to describe that what you just said, because Minako, again, I really appreciate what you said during the answer. You said it's not only that we are immigrants, but also we are humans. You know, again, regardless what your background and regardless what nationality, you know, we are, I think it's important that when we really treat each other with respect and a fairness, I think this is what we need today. You know, again, I agree with you at the beginning, is this country was built by the immigrants. You know, if you study American history long enough, that you know that this country was built, and a lot more experts and, you know, historians, they all agree that without the earlier founding fathers, without those groundbreakers, you know, as immigrants, that this country would not come to where it is today. And of course, people like you as an artist, and over the years that I met a lot more immigrants and who have different backgrounds and different careers, they're all contributing to the prosperity and sustainability of this country.